Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Kingdom Animalia, and in that we are studying topic Phylum Hemichordata. Now, hemichordates are the organisms that are worm-like. They look like worm, and wherever they are present, they emit the smell of iodine. That's strange. So we'll be studying about them today. One of the simplest examples of Phylum Hemichordata would be Balanolus. Now, this organism basically thrives or lives in marine regions, and it represents a worm. Also, whenever it reproduces or whenever it's growing or feeding, it tries and feed on another organisms, and just around this process it smells or emits the smell of iodine. Also, it does burrowing inside the soil just to take out those organisms and internalize its hunger. The organisms that belong to Phylum Hemichordata, basically their body are divided into three distinguished regions, and this three distinguished region will have their own function to do. Also, excretion removal process of waste is through just a single gland, which is the proboscis gland. Also, this gland has to be associated to the blood vessels, because blood vessels are going to collect waste from different regions, and then waste could be thrown away. Reproduction is always having two sexes, male and female. Now, asexual reproduction can also take place in few organisms of them. Being worm-like and emitting iodine, their structure of survival becomes very distinguished, and they represent a U-shaped organism. Phylum Hemichordata. Now, one of the simplest examples of Phylum Hemichordata is Balanolus organism. These organisms are marine in nature, and they have worm-like characteristics. They are a kind of worm. They basically are U-shaped, and they feed in them, or just to survive, these features are very useful. What they do is, for their survival purposes, they eat worms or insects. They burrow inside deep layers of soil and find a prey on insects on which they could feed. The body is divided distinctively in three different segments. The parts are trunk region, proboscis and collar cells. Now, these are the collar cells where the notochord would be provided or present. The notochord that actually gives support to the body are situated in this region. The nervous system in these organisms or the nerve cells are dorsally placed, and in other organisms it could be ventrally placed. The circulatory system has heart as well as blood vessels. Yes, they are not as compact or congested in other organisms, but there are blood vessels which does the blood supply efficiently. The digestive system is basically U-shaped with discrete parts for digestion, that the mid-dorsal ridge, the hepatic fissure, the hepatic region, etc. Proboscis helps in excretion. Now, proboscis is a part that belongs to them, and sexes, that is the male and the female, are separate. The striking feature of this organism, students, is that they are the connecting link, or they are the middle pathway between chordates and non-chordates. So they neither belong to the system of chordates, neither to the non-chordate segment. So students, today we came across phylum hemichordata, means half chordata, neither chordates nor semichordates. I hope students, we all here are very clear that hemichordata, neither they belong to the chordate part nor to the non-chordate part. They are the middle link and have various characteristics. I hope we all have very clear with this concept. Thank you.